Hi, Kate.
Hi, Molly.
Oh, you're there. I'm going to turn around. So would you like to just start by telling everyone what your role is at Chronicle?
Yeah, absolutely. So I am a senior acquisition editor at Chronicle Books. We're based in San Francisco, and we're an independent publisher. And we publish all kinds of very visual books and gift products. And as an acquisition editor, my job is to both come up with ideas and find ideas out in the world for art books and also art-driven gift products. So gift products run the gamut from very straightforward note cards and journals, stationery, and then more sort of content-driven games and art kits and guided journals and even novelty products like temporary tattoos. Sort of you name it, we would love to make it, and I would love to work with you on it.
Can you talk a little bit to how you actively find artists to work with and what some of the ways are that people can find how to put themselves in front of you and sort of how you're finding people out in the world?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I am always looking for new artists to work with. So if you are an artist, don't be shy about reaching out. People contact me all the time, and I'm always more than happy to hear from them. So let's see. I mean, I find new artists in my general sort of internet trawling, looking at blogs and sites online, like just this morning. And that could be very specific art blogs or not art blogs, but like this morning, the Jealous Curator featured a Japanese artist that I thought, oh, wow, that person's awesome. Maybe I should check them out. So online, I spend a lot of time looking in gift shops and seeing people who make, you know, their own products. That's often how we find artists is artists who have their own fine art practice or their own commercial business already where they're making goods, and then I'll reach out to them to see if they want to make something with us. I also work with artists who are represented by art reps, so it might come in that way. I go to a lot of the trade shows like gift show and stationery show and just walk up and down the aisles looking for new people. And what else? I mean, I just generally have my eyes open. People send me suggestions all the time. People reach out to me, and I reach out to people as well.
So you both work on gift product, but you also work on books. So we've worked on a book together. Is there a way for people to submit book ideas to you, like book proposals?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Chronicle has on our website, if you go all the way down to the bottom, some submission guidelines, and absolutely look those, and you can send your ideas to that general address, or I am more than happy to receive your ideas directly. And if you do just the most basic internet sleuthing, you can find my email address. It's on my website, which is katewoodrow.com. And yeah, I welcome book ideas and gift product ideas, and I really welcome specific ideas. Like, you can always just send me your portfolio and say, hey, this is my artwork, I'd love to work with you. But I really, really appreciate it when you do that, plus send a specific idea of something that you want to work on and that you think would be good for Chronicle.
Question might be, who's your customer for your parties, types of parties, weddings? Do you do that? Or, well, who is your customer, I guess, that would buy it?
Yeah, that's a great question, because we're always thinking about, you know, who's going to buy this product. And so Chronicle publishes a lot of different categories. So, you know, from cookbooks to children's books. So obviously those are different consumers, but I can just speak to sort of my consumer, or if you have a specific category. Do you have a specific category you're curious about?
Tea parties, like weddings, whimsical, elegant, and...
Well, that's the consumer. I mean, we do sometimes publish for that, you know, we publish for the bride, and we're always thinking about gift giving occasions. So we love to make things that are great for a bridal shower gift or a baby shower gift. You know, tea parties, well, tea is a topic of interest with Molly. We're working on a teacup book. And so in addition to gift giving occasions, we're also thinking about merchandising opportunities. So tea, for example, lends itself so well to merchandising, right? Because you could display a tea-themed book or stationery or gift product alongside teapots and teacups and tea towels and tea. And so if you're pitching an idea, it's great to sort of think through those things in advance, maybe spend some time in gift shops and visualize where your product or your book would live and alongside what other merchandise, because that's what we're thinking about.